Well, I'm just back from Zimbabwe, the city of Bulawayo in particular. Man, what a blessed time I had with Apostle Ken and his dear wife Beulah Haskins and Senior Pastor Morgan Matema and his darling wife, and of course all the other pastors and leaders. What an incredible church. So grounded in the Word, so full of love, well-structured, just an exemplary ministry. And, you know, to be invited up to ordain and be part of the ordination process with Apostle Ken of 70 pastors and leaders, it was momentous. It was absolutely epic. And I feel incredibly privileged. You know, we met up again after many, many years with Apostle Ken in 2019 when we were preaching in Victoria Falls with Apostle Vincent Dube. And we just connected, and our hearts connected, and of course with Pastor Matema as well. And to get this invitation to be a part of the ordination was absolutely such a privilege. I mean, I just stand in awe of God, and it was just amazing. You know, I had nothing to do with their training, you know, the education as ministers, the raising up as Christian believers. That was, you know, all the work of Apostle Ken and Pastor Matema and their wives and the other leaders. But I was just so blessed to be included in it. And it was, as I said, an honor and a privilege. We had a great time, ministered basically all day Saturday, most of Sunday. I had a week off, and I'll tell you about that now. And then the following weekend, we just had the one service on Sunday. We were going to do a prophetic seminar on the Saturday, but they've laid it over to next year, sort of March-ish, but we'll confirm dates. But what a blessed time. Sunday morning when we did the ordination, man, the power of God, you know, just laying hands on these precious men and women of God, and many of them being touched by God's power and glory and ending up on the floor and having a good session with the Lord there. And it was so powerful. Again, I just want to say, an exemplary church. Their hospitality, their love, the way that hosts attended to me, the honor that I received from Apostle Ken and his wife and all of the pastors and leaders there was absolutely magnificent. And just an epic moment, Sunday morning. I just felt I really need to push for healing. This was just absolutely fantastic. And one of the ladies who translated for me in one of the sessions, I had a word of knowledge about people that lost one word of knowledge, you know, amongst many for different things for healing. And it was for someone who had lost their sense of smell. And of course, this young lady, Beauty, came forward. She's the principal of the school. And as she said, since COVID, I cannot smell a thing, I cannot taste a thing. You know, it was like excitement rose up in me that finally we can just get revenge again on this COVID pandemic, COVID virus. And I tell you, I asked one of the ladies for some scent. I sprayed it here on my wrist. I prayed for her, for Beauty, laid hands and prayed for her. And I said, smell. And first of all, when I laid hands on her, she hit the floor. We picked her up, and then I said, how are you feeling? She said, great. I said, see if you can smell this. And I just put my wrist up towards her face. And the shocked look on her face when she breathed in, and she could breathe. She could smell. She just hit the floor again, bang, on the floor. So I called one of the ushers, and I said, get me a peppermint. We got the peppermint out, got two ushers. We picked up, I put it in her mouth, and I said, what do you taste? She burst into tears, and she said, I'm eating a peppermint. So it was glorious, and I know that others were healed. So what a joy to be able to take revenge on COVID. And then, of course, for 10 years or more, 12, 13 years, it has been an absolute passionate heart's desire to go and fish the Zambezi and Kariba again for the, you know, legendary tiger fish and the great bream that are there. And they blessed me with a trip. Apostle Ken took me, and I spent some time on the river. So that's included in the clip. It was just magnificent. What a blessed time. So I want to thank you all for praying, and for those who gave towards the trip to assist me with the airfare and with having money there that I, you know, which is essential. So thank you very much. I really appreciate it. And we have confirmed and tied up a strong link with Apostle Ken Haskins and Victory Fellowship. So we know that there's going to be great cross-pollination. So there's a few clips that has been showing while I've been speaking. But thank you, saints. The Lord bless you. And let's keep going with this kingdom word that we have, and see the Church of Jesus Christ established all over the world.